And so, hello. Today, first, before I discuss who I am, let me just tell you what we are going to be discussing. Today is day one of our 14 days of fire, and I have been charged with igniting kingdom entrepreneurs just to bring hope, to bring strategy, to bring ways that you can still profit, even during these economic times with the quarantine and things like that. You can still make money. The hand of God is still upon you. No matter what happens, Jesus is still on that throne, and his hand is still over his people, and he is still looking for his people and making ways for us as entrepreneurs to continue to bring in a profit into the kingdom of God for his glory, for his namesake. Let's all get together and have testimonies that even in a drought, even when the land was in a drought, okay, the Lord made my business, he made my home a Goshen. We didn't suffer lack. We still had sales. We still were able to take care of what we needed to take care of, even during these tough financial times. If you believe that this is going to bless somebody or benefit someone, please go ahead and share. And so today we are going to be talking about, I'm going to be sharing about two or three things that you can do, how to start and sustain a business on a budget. Because that is important. We want to be wise. We want to be stewards during this time. Yes, there's no lack in the kingdom, but we also, God also charges us at all times to be good stewards of what he has given to us, of what he has invested in us and what he has entrusted in us. And so let me go ahead and introduce myself. My name is Sade Banks, also known as Miss Bankable, and I am a business expert who develops systems and strategies to remove growth blockades and increase profits. So if you sell, I'm going to give a tip for product-based businesses and for service-based businesses, because although, yes, there are some universal principles, there are some universal laws that extend throughout all of business, there are certain strategies and certain marketing ways that you have to differentiate. Different, your website will be different. There are things to differentiate a product-based business from a sales-based business, from a service-based business, excuse me. So if you run a product-based business, one way that I suggest, typically one of the mistakes that I see entrepreneurs make is they, when they're first starting out in products, they order way too many products without even testing the market, right? So in wisdom, you want to make sure a great business practice, a rule of thumb for business, is to always test your market. Make sure that what you are selling, people want it. People desire it. If it's a need, it's obvious, like toilet paper, right? You're pretty much safe with that at this time, right? If that's what you're selling. But if you are selling consumer goods, more things like handbags or purses or whatever type of widget, you always want to make sure, even with toilet paper, right? But you know, you get the joke, right? You always want to make sure that you test the market. So one way that you can do this is to create a Facebook group or to create some type of group on social media. I know on different platforms, they have different ways that you can create groups where you are the moderator, you are the controller, you are the admin of that group, not only Facebook, right? The goal is to create a group where your target customer is. So you want to create that Facebook group, and you want it, the group, to be based on the products or the industry in which your business partakes in, right? And so that way, the goal is to be able to funnel in people, to funnel in potential clients, to funnel in those who would have an interest in your product or in your service. And one way that you can test the market, because you already have a gathering of people who love what you do, who love what you sell, right? So now you are able to test that market and to see what they are most likely willing to purchase or buy. So one thing that you can do within this group is to post your products in there, right? And then take note of the comments, take note of the shares, take note of ask opinions about the products, things of that nature. That way you're gathering intel about your client's taste and about their preferences in the products that you are able to put into your group, right? And so then that, then based on the information that you receive, it'll help you to make better, wiser choices in the inventory that you purchase, because inventory that does not have a high rollover, that does not have a high turnover, or that sells quickly, it begins to depreciate. Okay, so once it begins to depreciate, that's when you have to start putting things at a discounted price and putting things on sale. Once something's been sitting on your shelves or in your inventory for too long, it will bring you to places of liquidation. And that eventually, that does decrease your profits. I mean, you do not want to be known as a brand that is constantly decreasing your prices. Why? Because you are training your consumer, when you constantly have a bunch of sales and a bunch of discounts, you are training your consumers to just wait it out. Eventually, it'll go on sale. I mean, that's, we all want the best deals, right? Nobody wants to spend full price if they don't have to, unless it's an absolutely luxury good, like you're selling Gucci or Prada or something, right? Where there is a great pride in spending $3,000 for your handbag or $3,000 for your wallet, right? No. So you have to make sure to always test your market before you're ordering a lot of products. This will save you a lot of money. Let me share a story with you. I actually owned a private label handbag fashion company. I had a business partner and we owned it together. And so we went to New York. We are new entrepreneurs. We are excited. We are in New York City in a warehouse district. She took her tax money and she got us all of this inventory. When I tell y'all, some of that inventory we sat on for like a year and could not sell it. Why? Because we did not test our market. So that is key. You have to know who's going to benefit from your products. Not only who's going to benefit from it, but who is willing to spend the money, who has the discretionary income to be able to purchase your products and your services. And then you want to make sure that you gather them together at some type of place. It can be a Facebook group, LinkedIn, whatever social media will allow you to create a group for free, because we're talking about running business on a budget, right? Then you can test your market and ask them questions. Now, this is important also. You just don't, in your groups, in your gathering places, you just don't want to just sell. You want to provide value. You want to provide content. So you can provide them useful tips. You can provide them blog posts. You can go on YouTube and pick out different videos that pertains to the industry, that pertains to their interest, and make sure that you're in there interacting with your people. They have to know, like, and trust you in order to be able to open up their treasuries or their wallets and support your business and buy your product. So just a quick recap, create an online group of some sort on some type of social media platform to gather your ideal target clients, okay? So, and if you need any help with strategizing some things that you can do, you can also, like I said, book me for a 30-minute consultation. Now, let's move on. Again, share if you feel like this is going to benefit somebody. Number two, if you have a service-based business, you can establish yourself as an industry expert in your field. So one of the things that I know that the Lord Jesus is looking for in his kingdom entrepreneurs is for us to give him a seat at high tables. Everybody, okay, now we're getting into kingdom stuff. Everybody brings their God to the table. The Bible says that every man walks in the name of their God. So these CEOs, these high-ranking corporations, Target, and all of these people that are in charge, these people that are making decisions, these managers, they bring their gods to the table. You know, we as Christians, due to, unfortunately, this thing in the church, not all churches, but this overarching belief that, you know, business is not of God. God is not involved in business. Or if you seek to be rich, you're going to be evil, or all rich people are evil, or just these poverty mindsets, right? So, but these other religions, these world religions, they understand and they know that when I come to the table, I'm bringing my God, I'm bringing their principles, I'm bringing their philosophies, I'm bringing their beliefs to this table, and we're going to make decisions that are going to impact this whole kingdom or this whole business. Okay, so we as Christian entrepreneurs, as kingdom entrepreneurs, have to get in the mindset that when we are conducting business, when we are in certain places, when we are doing certain things, we are bringing Jesus Christ to the table. We are bringing forth his voice. We are bringing forth his righteousness, his integrity. We are bringing forth his law and his mind into that place to be able to shift or change atmospheres, to shift or change nations, businesses, organizations, things of that nature. So it's very important for us to understand and get that concept, especially during these times. So you want to establish yourself as a thought leader. Now, how can you do that? This is some ways that you can do that, and you can do it for free, because we're talking about how to run your business on a budget, okay? Now, you can blog post on some websites. So say if your service is you walk dogs, right? So you will go to different blogs that are looking for blog content writers, and you can give tips, hints. You can do vlogs, however, concerning dogs, concerning dog walking, different profitability ways that you can be profitable in dog walking. You can go to that blog, you can submit your article, and then on that article, you will, of course, put your name in there. If they allow you, we'll put your website or how they can further reach you, and then that will draw people into your website. This will draw people to where you are. Right. And so you can create your increase your subscribers, increase your potential buyers. And that's such a smart idea, because it's all about getting in the face of your potential clients and your potential customers. So if you go to a blog, a website where it's in your industry, where your potential client is, you are going to drive very profitable potentials, very high possibility of leads, very great quality leads to your website, or where they can make different purchases to book you, right? So one website where you can establish yourself as a thought leader is www.qura.com. I will repeat that. It's www.qura.com. And it's basically a whole community network where people come on and they ask different questions. You'd be surprised by some of the questions. But nevertheless, they ask questions. And then you, establishing yourself as a thought leader, you can set the parameters of the questions that you see that come into your mailbox. You can set those. And then you can go and so every time somebody posts a question within your industry, within your level of expertise, you can go and answer their question. And if you do this enough, you gain points, you gain rank, you know, and you can establish yourself as a thought leader. And again, use this as a method to draw people to your website, draw them to your books, draw them to whatever you are doing that makes a profit for your business. So here is a list of some very cheap to free resources that you can utilize to help you to continue running your business during this time. One of the things that we have to be most cautious of, which you should be cautious of anyway, is making sure that you are keeping track of your finances at all time. I know GoDaddy has a $10 a month bookkeeping solution. If you are not gifted in math, if you are not gifted in keeping your financial records, okay, you should be looking for some type of a bookkeeper who can gather all of the information that you need, all the financial information that you need. You have to be having balance sheets. You have to be having income statements. The IRS requires all this information. And plus, the numbers don't lie. They tell you the healthiness or the sicknesses within your business that need to be corrected, right? So that's important. Numbers tell you a whole lot of information. Perhaps I will do a video on that one day. So GoDaddy.com offers the $9.99 a month bookkeeping solution. Next, another website that you can use is Fiverr, F-I-V-E-R-R. And Fiverr offers an array. It is people from all over the world who can do everything from do your memes from you to do your memes for you, to manage your social media, to write your blogs, to maintenance your website, to create your logo. They can do all of this. Now, keep in mind, you do get what you pay for, but it is a brilliant resource to use to help you to manage and to create your branding and your business going, right? So they have, in fact, they have a 3-page website on there for like $150 if you want to do it on WordPress. So that is a very valuable resource. I highly urge you guys to go there if you want to run your business on a budget. Next, you can also remember when we talked about earlier about having a group of people that you can gather that are potential clients? Well, MailChimp, that's a customer relationship management tool, and it is free. It's called MailChimp.com. So you can use that to gather your leads, to gather email subscribers. That way you can keep in communications with them. I know a lot of you are getting emails, right? From Walmart and Sam's Club and Target and all of these places. They have a customer relationship management software. It's not like basic. You can really do some complicated, robust tasks in MailChimp in order to manage your customer base. Next, another resource I want to share with you guys is called Pixabay. So that's pronounced, so it's spelled P like Peter, IXABAY, .com. And you can go on Pixabay.com to get free stock photos. Free stock photos. There's over 9 million options. Again, I unction you, if this is benefiting you, if you know it would benefit others, go ahead out and share this. Pixabay.com. And so if you have, especially if you are a service-based business or you like to create a lot of memes for your business, you do a lot of social media work, Pixabay is an extremely valuable resource to help you to keep your branding, to help you keep the professionalism, the cleanliness, that will attract people to your brand. So that sums it up for today. Again, my name is Sade Banks, AKA Miss Bankable, and I am a business building expert. If you have any questions or you want to see how you can continue to grow your business during this time, or even start your business during this time, it's so important that you have the proper systems, the proper ideas, in alignment before you go out and start your business, right? And you also need the spiritual backing, because the Bible says that he gives you the power to get wealth. So people out here is tapping into all different sources to get to make their businesses successful. Why don't you tap into Jesus Christ, right? So we can do all of those things, talk about all of those things. My consultation link is in the bio. You all be blessed, and I will keep you all in prayer. Bye-bye.